I, 27 male, am literally the second and safe choice for my GF, 29 female. Basically what the title says. So I have known my girlfriend for around 4 years now, she was a friend of a friend. Around 6 months back I asked her out but turned me down saying she is not interested. I was disappointed but didn't press her. After about 2 months I met her at a get-together and she impromptu asked me if I was still single? I said yes and then she asked me if I was still interested in dating her? I said yes then she said now she was also interested so maybe we can meet tomorrow and see about it. We met the next day and decided to give it a try. And honestly it's been an amazing 4 months. We really enjoy each other's company and we are both sure that it's going to be a long-term relationship for us. So anyways I was hanging out with friends last weekend and there were two guys there who I didn't know well. We were just talking when someone asked one of the guys if he was dating anyone. He laughed and said no, there was a girl, he took my GF's name, who was pursuing him hard for a serious relationship a few months back but he was just interested in having fun so she finally gave up after some time, timeline matched. So when she turned me down she was pursuing him and when he wouldn't commit then she asked me out. It just left a funny feeling in my stomach. When we were hanging out afterwards I mentioned that I ran into. She was visibly stressed so I didn't say anything further. I don't know how to feel here Reddit. Should I ask her about it? Do I even have the right to ask her about it? It just feels like she is settling with me because she couldn't get her first choice to commit to her. Judging by the timeline, you might have simply asked her out while she was actively pursuing someone else. If anything it's a good quality, albeit unfortunate timing. This comes down to you needing to communicate with her and see if it's something you can move past. Isn't this just how dating works? You're interested in someone, date them for a bit, it doesn't work out. Then you date someone else and maybe it does. She was seeing someone when you asked her out and she turned you down. When that was over, she asked you out. How is that bad? I don't get why you're taking this as an insult. You're in a good relationship with a woman you like a lot. You won. I'm willing to bet the other guy recognized you from social media. Even if your girlfriend doesn't follow him, if he follows your girlfriend friends he had probably seen your pic with her. His response seems like a very odd one to, are you dating anyone? He's going to mention, by name, a girl he was seeing casually 4-6 months ago? No, my man. He is trying to mess with your head, by putting his own spin on what went down. Don't fall for it, and don't bother your girlfriend with it. Edited to add. Even if his story was true, it wouldn't matter now. So you asked someone out who was busy dating, trying to date someone else at the time. That relationship didn't work out for her so she moved on and starting pursuing someone else, that someone else being you. She was unavailable when you asked her out, she came back to see if you were interested once she was free. I'm pretty sure that's just called dating, what exactly is the problem? If you want someone who has never dated anyone else and has waited and look only at you ever you're going to be waiting the rest of your life for that person. If in the initial stage of your relationship with her someone asked her out you would hope she said no right? If she's given you every reason to think she's faithful in your relationship now and you guys are doing great, I would let it go. You weren't technically together so she didn't do anything wrong, and plenty of people casually date, talk to multiple people at the same time before they decide. Maybe she's realized how much a better choice she's made with you. You asked her out when she was actively involved with this dude, it sounds like. He refused to commit, so she dropped him. This is just how dating works. It's not a matter of going after you as a formally established plan B, it's that she wasn't involved, you weren't involved, she checked to see if you were still interested, to see if you might click. Common advice for coming out of a breakup, even for an informal situation, is to get back out there, not, go hunt down the last person who expressed interest and pursue them since they're the safer bet. I say this gently, but you are doing your girlfriend a massive disservice assuming something so negative of her. Is this not simply dating? If she had maintained communication that felt like stringing you along, then I get it. Other than that, you're in your head too much. Edit. Typo. I feel like I can't trust her now. I am 25 male. My girlfriend 21 female, went to a concert tonight. Turns out she went with some friends, a married couple, and also her ex. 23 male when I asked her before the concert she only mentioned the friends and that she was expected to go. After the concert we talked, said good night and she still didn't mention anything about her ex. I found out later tonight cause one of her friends posted a picture of all four of them in her story. So I feel like my trust has been a little bit played with? Especially her knowing I have past trauma from EX's cheating and bad communication. I think she could have easily mentioned her ex was going. Or that her ex was there with them. I've caught her hiding little weird stuff from me before. Stuff that I think we can talk about openly and have expressed this to her. I rather have communication than find out in other ways. And this kind of just adds up to the pile of things she has not mentioned to me. So I definitely feel a little like I can't really trust her. Like maybe there is things I don't fully know? Am I just thinking irrationally? I'm thinking of breaking up. Update. She called me twice. I didn't answer. And texted me saying she understands I'm upset and ready to talk whenever I'm ready. I sent her this. You omitted the truth once again. I hope you grasp the fact that it wasn't okay. I'm disappointed and right now I can longer trust you. Without trust I can't do this anymore. Wish you the best, take care. I just send her the picture with, you left out a fairly important detail about who you were going with. I don't know how I can be with someone who isn't trustworthy and I need some time to think about things on my own, so don't expect to hear from me for a while. Then take a few days on your own to decide how you feel. From your other comments, personally I think she's shady. Update? She answered. Good morning, I'm sorry I didn't tell you. It is currently 7:23 a.m. I haven't slept overthinking and shit. I'm glad I have the day off but I texted her this at 12:10 a.m. I think you could have told me your ex went with you guys. Especially with all the talks we have had. It could have been that easy, Jay. She is probably getting ready for work and starts at 8 a.m. I'm hoping for at least some sort of response here soon. Right? You sound too mature for this relationship. Make sure you screenshot the story and confront her about it. She should have definitely mentioned it. I would be extremely clear with her. It might not seem like a big deal going out with friends and your ex, but it is to me, because you didn't tell me. So please just tell me up front next time, otherwise I feel like I can't trust you because you aren't open with me. Yeah, that's weird. Almost sounds like a double date? I'd just speak to her, tell her you saw the post of all four of them and just wondered why she left out she went with her ex. Do you know anything about them, e.g. when it ended, if it was mutual or a bad breakup? Omissions of truth are still lies. I love when people try to deny that. She's garbage wastebasket. I, 22M, found out that my girlfriend, 22F, of 1 year cheated on me twice and I am devastated. 2 days ago we were talking casually about sex and she told me that the last time she had sex before me was a lot of months ago. That was in direct contradiction of what she had told me sometime in the past, which made me very suspicious of her. When she went out with her friends, I did the horrible act of going through her Facebook messages. I already felt like garbage for even doing this. But after searching I found that she had cheated on me twice. Once with a on's Tinder date and once again on vacation where she had sex with a stranger on a beach after drinking too much. I also found some messages regarding me, where she would criticize my personality and our sex life and then immediately saying good things about her cheating experience. Her friends were also pretty supportive of this. We broke up after I told her everything. At first she kept denying everything even after I told her that I searched. She started crying and begging but I went home. However, I will still keep seeing her every day in uni for a couple more years. I am now unable to sleep and I always feel shaky and ill. I can't get the vivid image of her cheating with me out of my mind and I have thrown up multiple times because of it. I am also full of insecurities about what I read and I am really scared of the months to come. I can't eat or do productive things, I'm in fourth year med school at the moment. Please tell me what to do. Very sorry to hear this, my friend. You've gone through a traumatizing experience. If you can afford it, then I would recommend you see a therapist to help process your emotions and find emotional peace. If paid therapy is not an option, then there are some great mental health podcasts out there that are the next best thing. Wow, her friends actually support her to do this? Disgusting, keep them far away from you. First off, humans suck. Second, have you sought professional helps like therapy? Self-care is huge. Also, developing mature coping mechanisms is coming to be key being in the medical field. What do you do for self-care? Meditation, art, poetry, etc. Hobbies? I had a girlfriend 2.5 year who I was thinking about proposing. I don't have evidence that she was cheating on me but I had great suspicion. I was wrecked. This was 12 years ago. So it's hard to say what I did, it was hard. I mean honestly like, who cares? She sure as hell didn't, so why should you? Don't waste your energy on someone who doesn't deserve it. Act as if she did you a favor. Clean break, no marriage, no kids. You will find someone better in time. You owe it to yourself to crush the rest of that schooling and not let her completely derail all of that hard work. I am sorry, bro. But focus on the positives. Your fourth year med school. That's almost as big dick as it gets. Laugh your way to the bank, and if you see her, laugh in her face knowing she gave up a good guy who's GPINF to be a doctor for sex with a stranger on a beach. What a dumbass. About the cheating, she did this. This is her. This is who she wanted or wants to be. Those are her standards for herself, her morals, and her way of treating others. Pull yourself out of this situation and conversation. Nothing you are, did, or said is the reason for her cheating. It's solely on her. Even if there were issues between you or something missing for her, she could have just told you. Moving on. Be selfish but kind to others and yourself. Pull yourself up and force yourself to be productive, to get better at a hobby, anything you can grow any kind of self-worth from. The worst you can do is wallow in self-pity, shame, and insecurities. I wish you the best. Since you are studying med, you surely know about mens sana in corpore sano. Hit the gym and don't think about it. You will be alright. Her friends were also pretty supportive of this. Fuck those people. Just once in a while, I'd like to read a story here about women who don't think cheating is fine and dandy. Just found out my crush is an anti-vaxxer. I was talking to my crush today and he randomly asked me if I was vaccinated. I was wearing a mask and he wasn't. When I said yes, he proceeded to ask me, "Why did you get it? You don't care for your health." Face with rolling eyes, I was just like. And in my head I was like, because I know he does drugs, so what exactly is this health he is speaking of? Crush gone now? My crush is an anti-vaxxer, I know he does hella drugs. Should be an easy answer. Op has bad taste confirmed. Lol, are you vaxxed? Would be my number one pre-date question, to be honest. Crush. Crushed? Bro. You can't trust the vax because you don't know what's in it. Lack of testing, and long-term health risks. Also, bro. Does street drugs brewed up with who knows what inside some hillbilly's asshole? Cognitive dissonance much? Run. You are infatuated with a moron. Start looking for someone who isn't distracted by conspiracy theories and who is capable of rational thought.